Hi guys, welcome to the C2C Mentors TWD session, TV Topper, the way we call it as. And we have a topper today. Trust me, this guy is a superhuman. Now, I'm going to tell you a story, and I am very sorry you're going to get flabbergasted, that's for sure. So, Dhruv, one of my online students, he started his preparation last year. He converted KJ Somaiya. He converted KJ Somaiya with 99.40% time. He got into KJ Somaiya ka MMS, but as always, he was kind of gunning for something really big in life. He wasn't really happy with the MBA. He repeated CET, which is very common thing because people do repeat CET when they're in Sidnam, KJ, Wellington, whatever. But very few people actually make it to Jamnalal Bajaj. So Dhruv repeated CET. He studied, I think, only for 40, 45 days. He's gonna explain everything. And he scored 99.99%. So this is gonna be a life-changing video for you all. So I would request you to kind of settle down and whatever he's saying, make a note of that and like this video and download this video because this can actually help you to get into Jamnalal Bajaj next year. So Dhruv, welcome aboard, buddy. Thank you
Hello,
so
sir.
much for sharing some minutes with me because I know your schedule is quite busy. So fine. So we would love to hear your background first, and then we're gonna start with your CET कि लास्ट ईयर कैसे करा था, इस बार अपने कैसा करा. सो ओवर टू यू बड़ी.
So, good evening, sir. Basically, I'm a civil engineer by profession, and I'm a 2017 VJTI pass out. After VJTI, I got into Oberoi Realty. So I had a work experience of 2 years out there. So that's when I decided that being a civil engineer, the pay is not much. So and I wanted to do business from start. So I thought that in order to get increase the package or something like that, we need to do hard work. So that's when I decided that I'll go for CAT. But I was not I couldn't clear CAT because of some I had a prayer from start only. I couldn't clear JEE also. So that's because I have a pressure of negative marking. So then that there was CET one opportunity which I had. So I thought let's go with that. And then I had given CET in 2018 also, but that was just for time pass. So that's when I got to know the idea that CET can be cracked. So I started studying from 2019. I gave my first attempt. So that was sorry 2018 I guess. That's when I got 127. So I got into KJ Somaiya. So KJ Somaiya, from start only I thought that I wanted JV. So I had a target clear in my mind. So I started studying hard and then I got into and it's basically in the month of January I started studying for CET. And I was working from 9 to 6 at my college, and that's when right night in the 2 hours I started studying. Like from 10 to 12 I made a point that I'll study every day because the I had only 45 days, and so I decided that in 45 days I'll give 40 45 mocks. So basically 2 mocks on weekends and 1 mock every day. So that's when I started increase bucking up because I knew that the time is less and I had to crack it because I was not enjoying what I was doing. So
True.
I decided that I'll work hard. So
So Dhruv, पहली बात तो ये बहुत क्लियर है दैट सी आई मीन इट्स अ डिफरेंट फैक्टर ऑल टुगेदर दैट यू वर नॉट हैप्पी ओवर देयर इन केजी सोमैया व्हाइल डूइंग द एमएमएस बट मे बी यू वर नॉट हैप्पी सी बिकॉज़ देयर आर अ लॉट ऑफ पीपल देयर 119 स्टूडेंट्स दे आर स्टिल देयर दे आर एंजॉयिंग दे हैविंग लाइफ दे दे हैविंग फन बट यू पर्टिकुलरली वर नॉट हैप्पी बिकॉज़ दैट वाज नॉट समथिंग यू रियली वांटेड फ्रॉम डे वन
Yes.
You because you always wanted Jamnalal Bajaj,
Yes.
and because you have a great background as far as academics is concerned, and you always wanted it. Maybe because of that, you couldn't enjoy that. Maybe it's not for you, and you thought of giving it one more shot. Now, what I want to ask here is, let's talk about the psychology or what we call in MBA jargon, emotional quotient, right? Wasn't it risky for you कि यार अगर मान लो because अगर मेरा CET नहीं होता है तो मेरा MBA में भी ज्यादा ध्यान नहीं लगेगा. And next year is going to be my second year, and then economical situation. Or you were like, sure, you know what? Let me go for it. I'm going to nail it. Was it just a try or it was a confidence?
So basically, it was a confidence, sir, because I knew that 127 I was just there. So 99.4, I was just there.
Right.
I knew that getting 20 marks more will be a difficult task, but I can at least try. So that's when I decided that let's do it. Finish. Mm. I had a target clear in my mind. I wanted to do it. And so I started working hard. I was not thinking anything else. Like I had left like for KJ, I left the exams. Like as in I was not studying at all. So I was very serious towards CAT because CET. So because I knew that, and basically my exam was, I'd completed my trimester 2 exam. And that's when I started studying. So 45 days, I knew that I could make it because last year also I had studied for 2.5 months. And that's when I got to know that got 127. And I knew I had a first-hand experience of getting CET. So I knew the strategy was fixed in my mind. So the only thing I knew was that the mistakes which I had done last year, I just had to improve on that.
Right.
So that's what, it was a risk, but I decided that I'll go ahead. And I had a confidence that I can do it. So I got started. I was never thinking on a negative side. Nahi hua toh, what will happen? I decided that let's give the CET. Then agar, if it doesn't happen, then we'll figure it out what we can do. So I was never on the negative side.
Okay.
I'm asking you this question, Dhruv, is basically the point here is that we, like a lot of students, they feel that, you know, yaar, quants, matlab engineer, you know, engineers ko quants achche se aata hai, isliye ye log topper chale jate hai. So, kahin na kahin engineers ko wo, you know, kind of typical ek ye bhi mil jata hai, ki yaar, nahi yaar, engineers will do good everywhere. But now when you talk about CET, I think CET is a fair game battle for everyone, because quants ka wahan pe itna zyada portion hota hi nahi hai. So, you are an engineer, like, definitely, like, you know, because वहां पे तुझे एक एडवांटेज नहीं मिल रहा था कि बिकॉज़ कॉन्स तो उतना ज्यादा है नहीं, तो वहां पे वर्बल था, डीआई था, तुम्हारा लॉजिकल था. व्हाट वाज योर स्ट्रेटजी सेक्शन बाय सेक्शन, इफ यू कैन टेल अस?
सो बेसिकली सर, आई फॉलोड योर 60-60-30 स्ट्रेटजी. सो बट दैट स्ट्रेटजी वाज सेक्शन वाइज. सो व्हाट आई डिड वाज आई स्टार्टेड, सो कमिंग फ्रॉम एन इंजीनियरिंग बैकग्राउंड, सो आई थॉट दैट आई कुड कंप्लीट द क्वांट सेक्शन फास्ट. सो व्हाट आई डिड वाज आई डेडिकेटेड फर्स्ट 40 मिनट्स ऑफ टू क्वांट. एंड To my surprise, this time quant was easy for me. I was basically from the third slot. So within 35-40 minutes, I could complete quant section. So that's when, and that was all in one shot only I had done. So that's when, after the quant section, I knew that I was following your strategy. So I was thinking that let's go ahead, because during the mocks also, I was following that strategy itself. That was working for me. So what I did was from quant, I then went on to verbal. So our verbal, I just started doing all the easy questions. I left the RC questions, and then I started doing verbal. So I knew from day one, from the first and the second slot, that there was some new pattern. But new pattern doesn't make a difference as far as I see, because the logic is the same. So it just creates panic situation. But I think if a student is thorough with what he knows in verbal or what the concepts are, he will surely crack the verbal section, even if it is a new pattern. So then I had completed around 30-35 questions. Whatever speed I was going, I just completed 30-35 questions. Then I went back to abstract. And abstract this time was difficult on the lengthier side for me. Mm-hmm. So I thought I could do only 10 or 15 questions in the first block. So it was creating a pressure, but I thought that let's leave it now. And then last thing, I went on to logic. I left all the puzzles. I left all the critical reasoning questions. What I did was only the traditional logic and the direction questions. So by the end of 60-75 minutes, I could complete around 100 questions. So, so my genuine attempt was around 160 this time.
160 genuine attempt.
Yeah. So 160. Yeah, I am pretty. Yeah, it was 160. So after that, the next 60, I knew that next 60 minutes are going to be difficult, because I need to go on the tough questions now. So that's when I started logic first. So I did critical reasoning questions first, because I knew that what mistake I had done was I'd wasted time on puzzle. I'd wasted 15 to 20 minutes on puzzles and I couldn't crack. So that's when that was the place where I lacked. And I knew that I had to.
Did you do the same thing this year, or you just ignored puzzle to get the end?
I just ignored the puzzles, and in the end, I had given only 10 to 12 minutes. So only 10-12 minutes I had given one. I had only given 10 to 12 minutes. And so then I started doing critical reasoning questions. Once I was done with critical reasoning questions, I went back to abstract because I knew that abstract would take a lot of time, but I could clear it. And I was sure on that, I would get the answer because when I was giving mocks, the average was around 20, 21. So I knew that I could get the abstract questions right, even if I'm taking a lot of time, because now the next 60 minutes was accuracy. If I concentrated on accuracy, I could surely get it. And then I completed my abstract questions and then it was verbal. So I started picking up one RC. I picked up one RC and I was just, and that again, I used your strategy itself about the, like reading the questions and then going back to the, I don't remember the word which you were using in that term, but it was just judgment based. I was taking it from the RC and then I was searching it for the question and then
guesswork sort of a thing.
Guesswork. So that I was done. So by the end of 120 minutes, I was done with around 145 questions and 145, 150 questions. And then in the last 10 minutes, I started doing puzzles. So there were some 7 puzzles. Out of that, 2 I had already done. So that was one was based on the direction, the normal direction. And one was, I don't remember, but one was
a
small puzzle.
How many puzzles were doable out of the entire slot?
So there were, I guess there was 8 puzzles. So three to, if a person is strong, you see, I'm not strong in logic. So, so I couldn't do 4 puzzles, but if a person who is strong in logic can surely do 4 puzzles. Because 2 are easy, 2 are difficult. But if you give time properly and allot the times to each and every section properly, then you can surely crack the 2 easy, difficult puzzles. Because the thing is that you need to find one connect. If you have that one connect and it goes faster, that's the only logic. Because of the time, sometimes that connect doesn't, we do not get that connect and that's where we waste a lot of time.
That's right. That's right. See, I mean, credit goes to you, no doubt about it. I mean, like, my efforts were like 0.001%. I mean, the entire credit goes to you because you followed that strategy very well, and more than that, you executed that very well. Because I tell you, since last year, I have been telling students that do not take puzzles pehle. Keep them later. Like, you know, thoda baad mein le lo. Do not kind of, you know, stuck in puzzle at the initial level. You did it. There are other students, they also did it. Those were 99.97, 99.95. And you guys can see the results now. So again, you follow the strategy that helped you, and it's a good thing that you actually kept puzzles in the end, because that's where your score got jumped. Jo apne 2018 mein nahi kara tha. So fabulous thing. So this is something where, you know, we can learn. Okay, fine. So the another question that I want to ask you is, how did you prepare for every segment? So DI ke liye tumhara strategy kya tha? LR ke liye kya tha? Verbal ka kya tha? I mean, definitely, jo bhi humne online kara tha, usko chhod ke. Anything extra that you did from your side, you know, because of which you got that hold on that particular section?
So other than extra thing which I did was the fractions and the like all the fractions I had learned, all the cubes, all the squares, because I had seen in CET 2019 and 2018 also that they are targeting is the fractions. So they purposely give the decimals and fractions just to reduce the speed. So I knew that the only thing I worked on was fractions and cubes. I used to revise it every day, and sometimes I used to write also. So that's when I got hang of those short questions, fractions and the cubes and everything. And the DI was basically difficult logic which had to be cracked like CAT. The only thing was fractions. Yeah, everything was straightforward. The only difference was fractions. So if you're good at fractions, you can easily do it because they're just targeting you on the calculation speed. They want to reduce your speed because of the calculation. That's the only area which everyone should work if they're preparing to do fractions and cubes and squares. Because once they are done thorough with that, then they can easily do a DI section within 15 minutes. And I've done all the sections. Except for one, I had done all the DI questions.
Okay. Another question, Dhruv, for you is that, see, I have always been of this opinion that verbal is actually a game changer for CET section because it's 1/4 of the entire paper and not a lot of public is actually keen on verbal. What's your take on it? Like, and how you prepared for verbal?
So verbal, I wasn't doing much. The only thing I did in verbal was going through your videos. So going through your videos, I was preparing, and I was weak at verbal also. So as I was reading articles, newspapers, and then I used to search. I used to read the articles and then search for those words online, and that's how I prepared. So I basically made a notebook, and then I was writing the word meanings out there. So I was practicing, but I was not, wasn't getting much time because I had a difficult schedule, and I had to attend the college also.
Got it. Not a problem. So now coming back to your mocks. Okay. Now I'll tell you the normal perception about mocks. Dhruv, is that go for more mocks, right? More mocks, right? 40, 50, 60 mocks, right? And you also know that, you know, in like all the live lectures that you must have attended, like I've always told you guys that, ki bhai, even in my online videos for YouTube, पहले आप पढ़ लो, मेथड बना लो, कंसेप्ट बना लो, उसके बाद जितना चाहे उतना मॉक्स दो. This is one approach. Another approach is that just write mocks and mocks and mocks. What do you think? Like, which one is the best one to get a good result?
I think the first one is a better one, better approach, because if you know what you have to do and how your strategy is going to be, because CET is all about time. So it's how you approach that paper is important. Even if you give the mocks, but if you give it a wrong manner, that doesn't make sense. So like if you're giving 50 mocks also, yeah, it will increase your speed to a certain extent. But if you if you have a strategy in mind and if you approach that paper, that will help you a lot. This is what helped me, because whatever I used, like starting 5 to 10 mocks, what I used to do is just decide what is wrong, like what strategy I have to apply. Though I knew it as doing my strategy from 2019, but I couldn't clear JB. So I had to try a new one. So for first 10 mocks, I was just working on my strategy. So I used to make a strategy. I had noted down 5 to 10 strategies, and every mock, I used to use one strategy, and that's when I used to tick and I write the marks. So so then I just shortlisted 2-3 strategies, and that's when I started practicing on it.
Okay. Okay. So you actually gave 40-45 mocks in 40-45 days, whatever. That's the calculation. Okay. What was your schedule? Yeah. मतलब कैसे manage किया? This is like.
So.
Because 9-to-6 job, job नहीं था तुम्हारा career समय का MMS था. So you used to give mocks in the afternoon, CET वाला time period या night में आप देते थे mocks?
So first, it was basically starting like from Jan 24 when I started, that's when my trimester 2 got over. So after Jan 24, I used to give the mocks at night, because that was the only time, because I used to reach home by 7 p.m. and I was a bit exhausted. So by around 9:30 I used to start. So 9:30 to 12 I used to give. That was my schedule in the month of January and mid-February. But then it was, I knew that if you start giving mocks in the CET timings, it will be a bit helpful. So then I started giving mocks slowly I started taking it towards the evening time. Then that's I used to give by 7 to 9:30 I used to give. Then I started on weekend, but I made a point that on weekends I'll make it either in the first slot or like the timings of the first slot or the second slot. So in the weekends I used to give 2 mocks, so like from 9 to 12 and from 5 to 8. And the second day I used to give from 2 to 5. So that's when I got a hold of both the mocks timings.
Okay.
So.
And you used to analyze them thoroughly, or fir only weak areas aapne analyze kiya, ya fir how was it?
No, I used to analyze the mocks thoroughly. I used to practice all those puzzles once again. So I knew that why I did not get that puzzle, and I was analyzing why I couldn't get, and what was that link which I used to find. So after the mock, I used to take 15 minutes, 20 minutes, but it was like I was not seeing the solution. So what I did was I used to crack it. Even if it takes a lot of time, but yeah.
Okay.
So what happens is sometimes the logic patterns are similar. So the patterns are similar. It is just that they are the data they are in they are complicated by giving an extra data. So I was just getting a first-hand experience of all the puzzles. So how you solve it, what type of patterns do they give? Then that's how I get to know that, this pattern can be twisted and in another manner. Because many mocks I used to see that the logic of the puzzle is the same, but it is just that they have given extra data and that's
exactly just confused sort of. So, wow. Okay, great. Sure, hard work, man. Because it's like it looks very easy when you hear it, somebody saying that, you know, I would give two mocks on weekday. You see, because there are two sort of students that I've seen. One is like you, who will choose to sit at home on Saturday and Sunday and slog it out. And another, they might just want to go out, have fun, and kind of, you know, they sort of think about, you know, writing mocks maybe later on. So again, definitely, if you really work hard, and again, you ultimately achieve your dreams by sacrificing something. So I'm very sure. I mean, those are aaj ke baad, like you can party every single night.
Yeah, exactly. That's what I thought.
That's cool, man. Amazing. Acha, one question I'm going to ask you, my favorite AM. Dhruv, like we, as you know that, you know, we talk about EQ and IQ. You must have seen a lot of time we're seeing that. So on the D day, there are so many students, they work really hard. They give 40 mocks, 50 mocks, you know, everything they do perfectly. But on the D day, you know, something goes wrong. So what's your take on having EQ in place on the D day? Or probably you can develop EQ by giving your mocks. Do you think that that really helps?
Yes, it helps. So basically on the D day, you just forget what you've done in the mocks. You just
That's
keep
right.
in mind the all the formulas, all the fractions and whatever you've done. The basic idea is don't think about the result and don't think about the past. So whatever you've done in mocks, it's all over now. It is not going to make a difference on the D-Day.
Right.
So on the D-Day, while giving mocks, you need to be patient. Like there were many times when I've scored 90 also, 110 also. But I was like, yes, I can still do it. I just need a little bit of confidence and patience, because students lose hope that 90 aa raha hai ab nahi aayega, 110 aa raha hai nahi aaya. But I can tell you that I have never crossed around 130, 135.
Oh.
So 135, that too with random marking.
Okay.
So that was on a I was like pretty sure that I can make it. It is just on the D-Day, I need to be calm and patient and just work on my strategy.
Exactly.
Nothing else. So you just need
strategy
to be calm.
Would matter a lot.
Yes, strategy matters
That's
a lot. And you need to be calm. If you are like...
It happens, Dhruv. You know, there are people, they claim, you know, if you're scoring 120, 125 in mocks, you are sure shot going for general results. There are institutes, they claim like that, which is anyway, just bullshit, right? It doesn't really work like that. You might be doing fantastically well in your mocks, but then if you're not, you know, doing good on the D-Day, then you don't know, you know, what's going to be there. So cool. So that answers the question. Now, the other question that I want to understand is, there's a lot of students fall for this kind of thing, right? This sort of a practice that you must have heard, right? You know, that if you want to get into Jamnala Bajaj, you should be scoring 140 marks, 135, 145 marks, and people claim that ki bhai itna agar laya short shot jamal bajaj. So on the D-Day, Dhruv, tumhare dimag mein wo number tha kya, magic number ki nahi mujhe itna food nahi hai, ya you just went for a kill? What was your attitude?
D-Day, I was not thinking about the score, neither I was thinking about anything else, not about the future, what will I be doing, not about the college. I just had one thing in my mind clear, was that I want to do it and follow my strategy. And I knew my mistakes. So I just have to improve my mistakes from the CET 2019. So I made sure that I was not committing the same mistake once again.
Okay.
Because that mistake proves it's a very difficult thing. And you sincerely regret a lot if the result doesn't come through. So if you commit the same mistake once again, you will not be able to, you lose confidence. So it is only thing I would like to tell the students is that just be patient and just follow the strategy everywhere. Well,
right
from the start of the mocks till the D-Day, just trust your strategy and you will get your result.
And again, strategies, those who are practical, not anything which is like Havami, which be something like that, right? So that doesn't help. Anyway, cool. Now, finally, you got Jamnala Bajaj. You are going there for sure. And, you know, I'll tell you one more thing. Though you are 99.9% error, but the JB guys are going to vouch for you. Because you are unique. Unko pata hai ki bhai ye cage mein rehte hain, isne phoda hai. So that makes it a little bit more special. Plus, you always have the advantage because you have done 1 year of MBA. Same thing you will be seeing there. So that knowledge can help you actually, you know, kind of have a good CGPA in JB. which is again a plus point for you. But now, you know, having said that, you know, I've always found you very humble sort of a guy. How does it feel? Like, you know, are you like okay करके हाँ चलो हो गया पहले you know placings था मम्मी पापा का मेरा ये workout हो गया और कैसा मतलब how does it feel?
It's basically
that smiles tell me a lot of stuff by the way, but yeah, carry on.
It's a good feeling. So it's like you work hard and it's a blessing also which plays a big role.
I know.
So you work hard and you just only thing is always trust yourself while giving the papers and mocks. And you need to be, it's like JB mil gaya, that doesn't mean you still have 2 years and you need to work hard. So, life mein agar zyada paisa kamana, I'm a gujju. So, the only thing which in my mind is zyada paisa kamana. So, zyada paisa kamana hai, toh mehnat karo. Mehnat abhi mehnat karoge, toh 40 saal ke baad fayda hoga. But if you take rest right now and enjoy, abhi enjoy karo, baad mein baad kaam karoge, waisa nahi hota.
अंदर जाके भी मुझे बहुत मेहनत करनी है सो It was your hard work, no doubt about that. But that hard work was backed by your attitude. So this is what I want students to understand, that you have to have a right set of attitude. And then you have hard work with it. You are going to win the world. That's for sure. See, because you said it very rightly. Yeah, ki, I mean, you know, there are a lot of students, the dream of JB. Ki, mereko JB chalna hai, mereko JB phone hai, main JB jayega, main paisa kamayega, ye wo karega. But at the same time, we need to understand, ki, bhai, kitna mehnat tumne kiya. You say that you want to get into JB, but how much you worked hard? You say you're watching motivational videos, you know, somebody's coming on YouTube and telling you that hey, ho jayega, and then you're going, you know, having tea and you know, having party without putting hard work. So that's not gonna help students. So that's what I want to kind of tell them, that when you decide something that yes, you know, I'm gonna go for it, because you made it, like being a guy who did not compromise on MBA ka first year, you did everything that you were supposed to do. So you had your karmas in place, right? I'm doing my first year from KJ Somaya. I'll get my projects done. I'll get my presentations done. And you started your preparation after the examination.
Yeah.
SMB that you ignore that exam. So, uske baad you started and you nailed it. So, that's the only thing that I want people to understand, is that you don't have to be somebody with 160 IQ to kind of, you know, crack this exam. It's just that you need to be loyal to yourself, follow good strategies, follow good mentorship, work your way out, work harder, and, you know, just be consistent. And I think you've got to be there. And that's what makes you so special, Dhruv, because even after reaching out to top 10 B school, and it's not only Jamnagar Bajaj that you're getting, you're 19th for them. What's your rank, by the way?
11.
You are ranked 11 out of 140 lakh students. And, you know, even after that, you talk about hard work. It means a lot. That shows you as a person, buddy. Trust me, not only as a mentor or as a faculty, I'm proud of you. Your parents must be really proud of you and your friends also, because you have done something which is really, really important. And I personally want to thank you a lot. And I am glad, like, I am fortunate to have students like you. And I want to thank you for giving me this time for this session. I know thoda sa possible late tha, but still you took some time out. And you know, I'm really, really thankful for that. And I wish you all the very best. What specialization, marketing or finance?
So I'll go for finance this year.
Finance, huh? मतलब बात ही नहीं, मतलब तूने पहले ही बोल दिया था तो ठीक है. फाइनेंस इज समथिंग आई कैन डेफिनेटली हेल्प यू आउट, एंड अ लॉट ऑफ स्टूडेंट्स इन द जेबी सीटूसी के जो फर्स्ट ईयर अभी कंप्लीट करके सेकंड ईयर में गए हैं, तो दे कैन बी ऑफ ग्रेट हेल्प यू. सो गुड यार, गुड, आई एम फाइनली हैप्पी टू सी समवन हु नेल्ड इट. सो या ध्रुव, थैंक यू सो मच वंस अगेन एंड कांग्रेचुलेशंस बडी. मे बी कपल ऑफ अस डाउन द लाइन आई विल हैव यू सॉर्ट ऑफ यू नो इन सीटूसी मेंटर, सो दैट यू कैन आल्सो मेंटर सम स्टूडेंट्स एंड you know, kind of give them motivation. Fine. So that's it from my side. Thank you so much for joining in.
Thank you so much, sir.
Thank you.